Welcome to Shah's IAS Institute. In this video, we are going to look at an important topic for competitive exams, environment biodiversity, and this video is on Blackbuck. So you should have heard about Blackbuck. It inhabits low-growing grassy plains and thinly forested areas. They avoid densely forested and hilly areas. So they are primarily grazers and sometimes browse leaves of trees, fruits and shrubs. So they show sexual dimorphism. So this is a characteristic where the body coloration and horns are used to differentiate between the male and the female. So you can see the male and the female buck. The male is called the buck and female is called the doe. So this is the black buck species, and it is an endangered species. It is also known as Kala heron. So it's a species of antelope. It is one of the most beautiful and graceful animals of antelope species in India. And due to extensive poaching and habitat loss, black buck population has reduced drastically in the country. And this has been prominently in news because of poaching. The most striking feature of blackbuck is the long spiraling horns of the adult male, which have ridges from the base to almost to the tips. So they can grow as long as 20 to 24 inches. And the longest horns on record measure more than 28 inches. So both male and female have white patches around their eyes, on their inner legs, mouth, underside and on the rump. But the horns are there in the male, adult male species. So this is the black buck, and it had been in news because of the actor Salman Khan. He was recently sentenced by a local court to 5 years in jail and a fine of 10,000 for having poached two black bucks in a case almost 19 years ago. So it was in 1998, 19 years ago. The verdict came in 2017-18 now. So it is related to this killing of black bucks by him when he was shooting for the movie Hum Saath Saath Hai along with his cast and crew members. So here the members of the Bishnois community have been pursuing this case against Mr. Salman Khan. So the Bishnois communities are known for their beliefs which are associated with nature worship and wildlife conservation. So the wildlife department registered case of poaching of chinkaras and black buck against Salman Khan on the complaint of one Poonam Chand Bishoi, who was a crucial witness during the trial. So you should know about the Bishnoi community as such too. So it's a non-violent community of nature worshippers of Rajasthan. They are mainly in Rajasthan, but they are found in other states as such too, even in Punjab. So this community was founded by Guru Jambeshwar before 1451. So that was the time when a drought occurred in Marwar region in Rajasthan. So he laid down 29 principles to be followed by his sect as such. And one of them was Jeev Daya Palni Rukh Lilo Nahi Khave, means you protect the trees and animals. So Guru Jambeshwar, he directed the worship of Lord Vishnu. So that was what he directed his sect to follow. So the sect is also known as Vishnoi or Vishnois. And trees and animals are considered to be sacred by the Bishnois. Killing animals and felling of trees is banned by the sect. So blackbuck, it is a state animal of Punjab, you should know, but it faces severe threat from stray cattle, attack by stray dogs and habitat fragmentation due to change in land use and cropping patterns over the past few years. So it is mainly confined to this Abohar Wildlife Sanctuary in Punjab. So in early 2019 itself, as many as 8 black bucks died in this wildlife sanctuary in Punjab, and majority of them succumbed to their injuries caused by barbed wires while trying to escape from stray dogs. So actually what happens is, as we saw, they don't inhabit dense forests. So they are near these fields, and farmers, agricultural fields are protected by barbed wires. So these farmers, they use barbed wires. There's a ban on the sale and use of barbed wires by the district administration here, but still they are being used. And especially these cobra wires that have blade-edged iron wire mesh, they have been a major cause of worry and the reason behind these fatal injuries to black bucks during dog attacks. So when they try to escape from the stray dogs, they get entangled in this and they succumb. So Abohar Wildlife Sanctuary is actually an open sanctuary. It's spread across private land in 13 villages. And here we have the Bishnois living. Still we see this incident taking place, the black bucks dying due to these barbed wires used by the farmers here. There are other reasons also, like road accidents or falling into water storage tanks and concrete drains, which result in unnatural death of black bucks in this region. So the reason why these barbed wires are used by the farmers, though it is banned, is because they say the state government is not able to solve the problem of stray cattle. The stray cattle destroys their standing crops. So if the stray cattle is taken care of, there will be no need for the farmers to use these barbed wires and fence their farms. And this would eventually allow free movement of blackbuck and help them thrive. So this is a major issue here. So you can see blackbuck, it was notified as state animal of Punjab in 1989. And its presence in the state is confined to this Abohar Wildlife Sanctuary. So why? Because this has this unique habitat which is suitable to the the blackbucks, that is semi-arid plains consisting of agricultural fields and intermittent fallow barren lands, scattered sand dunes as such. So the Bishnois community is the one which mainly owns the land in Abohar Wildlife Sanctuary, and it says there were 3,273 blackbucks according to 2017 census here, but now they are gradually declining. In 2011, they were around 3,500. So the government, they allege, collects cow cess in the name of taking care of stray animals, but the problem continues and it's having its consequence on the blackbuck species too. So this is important. So that is it. Thank you.